Meeting the order of the Zoning Board of Appeals for Wednesday, October 19th. All rise for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Mr. Secretary, please call the roll.
Mr. Alexander?
Here.
Mrs. Moore Porter?
Present.
Mr. Campbell? Here. Mr. Diak?
Here.
Mr. DeBartolomeo?
Here.
Mr. Pearl?
Here.
Mr. Ramblett?
Here.
Mr. Nault?
Here.
Also in attendance is the Director of Planning and Community Development for Clinton Township, Mr. Bruce Thompson.
Thank you, sir. We have an agenda before us. Is there any additions or subtractions to tonight's agenda?
Only a change I have just on item one. It has it as 3,200 versus 2,300. That was the only thing I've seen to change or fix. For the address, 3,200 Remick Drive, it should be 2,300.
32,000.
Or 32,000. Yeah, it's supposed to be 23,000.
23, yes.
Yeah. Any other changes? Motion to approve?
So move.
Support. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carried. Good evening, everybody. A few housekeeping notes. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Clinton Township Board of Appeals. The Board of Appeals functions as a quasi-judicial body with specific powers and limitations as outlined in the various sections of the zoning ordinance and the state statutes. The zoning ordinances sets the standards the board must use in reaching any decision. Once a decision of the board becomes final, only the courts can modify or reverse that decision. This board is not empowered to change the terms or intent of an ordinance. Therefore, you must petition the Township Board of Trustees if you wish to amend an ordinance. Before a variance can be granted, certain requirements must be satisfied. Number one, practical difficulty must be demonstrated. Number two, whether strict compliance with area, setbacks, frontage, height, or bulk, or density would unreasonably prevent the owner from using the property for permitted purpose or would render conformity unnecessarily burdensome. Number three, a variance would do substantial justice to the petitioner as well as to the other property owners in the district, or whether a lesser relaxation would give substantial relief and be more consistent with justice to others. Whether the flight of the owner is due to unique circumstances of the property. Number five, whether the property is self-created. And number six, that the spirit of the ordinance is observed, public safety secure, and justice done. Thank you for that. Public comment. The chairperson should call all persons wishing to address the board during the public comment portion of the agenda and request their name and address. Comments will be limited to 3 minutes. Comments by persons must be confined to Zoning Board of Appeals business, meaning topics over which the Zoning Board of Appeals has authority and which involve Zoning Board of Appeals matters. Should the board decide that a response to a specific question by persons at the public comments section is needed, the board shall refer to the question to the Planning and Community Development Department Director or designee for review. Thank you. Just the way I run, going to run the meeting, and I do run the meeting this way, we will call an item. The secretary will read that item. The petitioner will come forward, state their name and address for the record if they want to. The petitioner will give their presentation. After that, I will open it up to the public for any comment on that specific item. Then I will come to the board and they'll ask questions of the petitioner and then we'll make a motion or decision on the item. So that being said, Mr. Campbell, first item.
First item of the petition is Julian and Taelor Heinrich at 23,000 East Remick Drive. Purpose of the request is for a variance to allow an additional 300 square feet to construct a roof structure to an existing detached garage. There were 31 letters sent to owners and occupants within 300 feet. None were returned as undeliverable. We did receive, though, two emails from neighbors. Both of them were supporting the request for variance. One of them was from neighbors across the street at 23011 Remick Drive, and the other one was from neighbors at 23016 East Remick Drive.
Thank you, Mr. Campbell. The petitioner here?
Yes.
Step forward. Name and address, if you so.
The address is 2300 Remick, Clinton Township. I'm Gary Rager. I'm the building contractor.
Okay. And your name is?
Gary Rager, R-A-G-E-R. Rager?
Okay. Sorry, didn't hear you.
Thank you. No problem.
Go ahead. State your case, please.
What we're requesting is that the particular lot is a very large lot. On the back corner of the yard, there is a building. The homeowner himself spent and his wife spend a lot of time. They like to do projects in the building. What they'd like to do is put a patio cover. They don't want to enclose it in any way. They want to be able to put a picnic table underneath it. They keep their barbecue inside that garage area, and they want to be able to have lunches and stuff back there without walking, you know, a big distance all the way back to the house, because they spend a lot of time there, that kind of people, and it's a large lot. So we're definitely not enclosing it in any way. It's just going to be a patio cover.
Anything else you'd like to add?
Pardon me, sir?
Anything else you'd like to add? Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Anybody from the audience like to speak to this matter? Seeing none, open it up to the board.
Question? Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, question. Is there a door that'll go from, let's say, the garage to that patio?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And it's strictly for their own entertainment use,
yeah,
no type
put,
of vehicle or anything like that?
Yeah, what they want to do, it's a long distance. If you look at the plot plan, it's a long distance from the house. And they're the kind of people that like to tinker and do stuff in their backyard, which is wonderful.
Sure.
They want to be able to put a picnic table out there so they can sit underneath it and put their barbecue. They can store their barbecue inside that building so they can have, you know, lunch out there while they're doing this.
Mr. Campbell?
Now, what's currently in the garage, the back there, the detached garage?
A whole bunch of stuff. riding lawnmower, a lot of equipment that he builds stuff with, you know, like tools and things like that. He's the kind of guy that does a lot of activity in his garage.
Okay. And right now, it appeared, at least yesterday, a vehicle parked where I think the roof structures.
Yeah, that's that's one of those old, for lack of words, back in the 60s, if you're old enough, one of those like hippie vans. I don't even know what VW van or whatever it is. And that's just sitting there. That's something that they picked up, and I don't know what their idea to do with it is. You know, maybe to restore it. I don't know. I have no idea.
But they're not trying to add an enclosed structure.
No, sir.
Okay.
This is purely a patio area.
Just as a comment, I think, as you know, there was already a variance for this, for the size of the garage. This, by adding a roof structure to the patio, it basically it has to count then as additional structure space. As long as you're not going to close it, though,
I think it's sort of a questionable
kind of thing.
I get it. I've been doing this 51 years, so I really get it, sir.
Yeah.
But yes, no, it's no enclosure for sure. It's going to be structured with posts, and there's going to be a picnic table and a barbecue on it.
Okay.
Anybody else? Motion's in order.
I'll make a motion to grant the variance as requested based upon the practical difficulty of the looking for additional outdoor covered living space, and based upon the practical difficulty of the length of distance from the house to the detached garage.
Support.
Motion on the floor, seconded, already seconded. Any further comment or questions from the board? Roll call, please.
Mr. Campbell, yes. Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Randlett?
Yes.
Mr. Alexander?
Oh, yes.
Mrs. Amorporta?
Yes.
Mr. Bartolomeo?
Yes.
Mr. Diak?
Yes.
Motion passes.
Thank you, gentlemen.
You're welcome. Take care. Next item.
Item number two is a request for a variance to allow a 44-square-foot electronic message center board at Five Stars Auto Care on 34410 Gratiot Avenue. There were, 32 letters sent to owners and occupants within 300 feet. None were returned as undeliverable. No written replies were received.
Petitioner, state your name and address for the record. Present your case, please.
Bryan Duquet of Signarama, 36886 Harper Avenue, Clinton Township, and I'm representing Five Star Auto.
Go ahead.
What we're doing is looking to replace the existing electronic sign that's in that property and put a new one in its same spot. We're still going to keep it within the existing structure that's there, so we're not adding or making the sign any larger. If you've seen the existing sign, it's not super attractive, so we're trying to enhance it and make it look a whole lot better with the new EMC. Customer likes to go with the 10 millimeter, so he's going to spend the money and do a nice high resolution, redo the panels, and just make a lot more attractive looking sign for Gratiot Avenue. Sign similar to other ones in Gratiot, EMC similar to other ones in Gratiot. Just looking to update it, make it nice and fresh.
Anything else you'd like to add? Okay, anybody from the audience that want to speak to this matter? I got one question. Sure. What's this current square footage?
I think that display, when I measure, it was like, it's an odd shape size, but it's like 28, 29.
Square foot.
Area. That kind of looks like a freckle in the middle of it.
Did we, Bruce, did we, well, it was probably before you, Bruce or Bob, did we do a variance on this years ago?
Not that I know of.
No? Okay. Open it up to board. Questions? Comments? Mr. Campbell?
Yeah, my reaction is this would be by far the biggest changeable copy electronic sign on Gratiot. There is none other on Gratiot anywhere that's even close to this size. And I think it's excessive given the township ordinance that calls for 20 square feet. Maybe something bigger than 20 might be allowed, but or possible. But we've only allowed exceptions in this neighborhood for, like, number one, the hospital at McLaren McComb has a large changeable copy sign. And there's a couple others that we've approved on Hall Road because of the width of Hall Road and the speed of the traffic. In my opinion, Gratiot is narrower than Hall Road, and the traffic does not move as fast. I can see no reason to need a sign this large.
Thank you, Mr. Campbell. Mr. Pearl?
Yeah, what have we allowed on Garfield?
No, except nothing, unchangeable copy, nothing big. Not that I could find.
I thought we did approve a larger one.
I didn't have it in my notes, I'm sorry.
What about the Midas sign? What was that?
That one's been there for years.
No, but we approved a change on that. Does anybody remember?
No.
The size? I mean, I know we approved it.
I thought maybe 30 square feet somewhere. I know we did a couple 30 square feet ones.
Yeah. 30 has been a common one that were approved. 28 is also a very common dimension for some of the ones that have been approved, but certainly nothing in the 40s.
What size is it now?
We're estimating it's around 28, 29 square feet. It's unfortunately hasn't been good display. This display's been off more than it's been on as long as it's been out there. So we're looking to put a quality display out. I think the Clinton Township sign is a 4x8. The city sign, I'm almost positive it is.
Well, they're an exception to the rule.
So, 4x8 or 4x10?
28 or 30 be done?
30 can be done because the tiles of the displays are 1 foot tiles. So if you guys know electronic signs, they're in any commercial brand, they're usually a 1 foot tile. So a 30 square foot would be 3 tiles tall by 10 tiles wide.
I'd go for a 30.
So I mean, that's what a 30 square foot would be. Coincidentally, I have a drawing of what it would look like as 30 square feet. I came prepared. So this is what a 30 square foot sign would look like. And I also have a four by 10. You know, being the sign is so wide, we're trying to work within the existing structure and still have it look proportionate. Because, Leigh, do you have that picture of the sign now? This lady is one of the owners.
How you doing?
How's this, sir?
I don't know if I can I approach him and show you? Or?
Sure. So, unfortunately,
that's the current one.
The sign's been out a lot, mm-hmm. and he's had to put banners on it and everything else to try to have something there.
Okay.
You'll see what it looks like, and he doesn't want to do that. He wants to make it attractive. And work.
Yeah, it looks
put
good.
Red on it.
So the tiles are 1 foot square.
Yeah, the EMCs are built 1 foot tiles.
1 foot tiles.
So
looks like the scoreboard.
If we go
looking at 10 by 3.
Thank you.
10 by 3,
right?
A 40
I
square
remember
board
this.
Would be 10 by 4.
Correct. Years ago.
Okay. And what size is that?
See that? But the black, this is the actual part of the sign. Can you see from the.
Yes.
It's kind of right in the middle there, just lost in this black sea.
You have to put black around it to kind of fill it in. So
okay.
Gotcha. I'm not sure the size. I don't
know. Gotcha.
Would the 30 square feet that Mr. Pearl mentioned be acceptable?
Layla, would you be comfortable with the 30 square foot?
I mean, ultimately, it's your choice, obviously, but I think it would, you know, we want to do different things and messages on there. And the larger the sign, then the more lines you can get. So rather than a one-word blurb, you might be able to get a message out there, you know, that that would attract or bring business. With the construction, everything going on lately, just drawing customers in has been a challenge. And, you know, it's a big building, a lot of square feet, a lot of overhead, and we're not, you know, we're just trying to make a change if we're going to spend the money, and they're not cheap. And it's obviously more expensive to go larger, but it's the right time to do it. Traffic, when we do have traffic with construction, it usually moves 55 plus miles an hour. I mean, people are always moving on Gratiot pretty good. So, you know, and really the traffic that's heading towards like Hall Road that passes me, you know, north, it has a good display, but from across that berm, which is rather large, and then the other side, it's and then the way the building's angled, it's really, I have a lot of people that pass me don't know where I'm at. So I'm really just trying to, the people that are looking for me, they can see me, the people that know I'm there will realize I'm there. And I think it would really be helpful for business and it would be appreciated. And, you know, maybe after Bryan hits me, that cost I might not quite go that big, but but I'd like to have the ability or flexibility too, you know, if any leniency would be great.
I did do an additional drawing of 4x10 so you could see an option too.
Okay, so. Thank you. Anybody else from the board?
Well, what about, so they're 1x1s. So what if we went 11, 3 high, that's 33.
Whatever the board's wishes
would be. I'm just throwing it out.
Yeah.
Sounds good. He said he's, what, 28, 29 right now? Would you say
you're right now he's about, it's an import sign, so.
Right, so.
I don't care. 33 is okay with me.
Why not 30? I mean,
the
30 is a common number of
years. He does have a big place.
Yeah.
It's quite a few bays.
It's got a lot
there.
Of frontage.
It is set back.
It's on an angle.
He has a point. You know.
There's no mistaking it when you're driving down Gratiot. You can't miss it.
I miss it all the time.
A question. Does it make a difference in the signage if we do 30 or 33? What's the difference that it makes?
In terms of how it fills the panel,
mm-hmm.
Well, give me an example. So as you can see, this is an 11 foot panel, so you don't have a whole lot of black on the two ends of it.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas if you go to a 10 foot panel, it just leaves more filler. So you're going to add about 6 inches, because the physical display size is exactly to the foot, because they're 1 foot tiles. And then you have your venting, your frame around it. There's about another 3 inches all the way around for frame. Mm-hmm. So we took what he had for sizes and what could we physically get to fit within it and have it look more complete.
Okay.
You know, we want it to look aesthetically pleasing as well.
Right.
I get a lot of customers that think I bought a small sign because I didn't want to put a big one in it. Why'd you go so cheap? You can hardly see that thing. And I get comments all the time on the size it's now. Like, all the time.
Well, the digital you'll see.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's totally this one different was technology.
Digital. My current one I showed you was illuminated, and that's half the problem. We went, you know, when it first came out, we were one of the first ones to put one out there. And unfortunately, it was slim pickings from reliable quality companies, and I got burned. You know, this would be my third sign. I mean, I got burned the first two times, and I believe Brian's going to put something. He's willing to back with a 5-year warranty, parts and labor. So I can't ask for more than that, which is better than I've ever gotten. So it's going to really make an impact, I believe.
Okay, thank you. Anybody else from the board? Motion's in order.
I'll say move to approve variance for 33 square feet.
I'll second.
Practical difficulty, Mr. Pearl?
Distance from the building to the street and the traffic pattern on Gratiot. And the next 2 years, they're going to be tearing up Gratiot.
A second.
It's been moved and supported. Any further comments or questions from the board?
And you can get a 33 in, right?
Just a comment. For a sign variance, there has to be an undue hardship, not a practical difficulty.
Okay.
Undue hardship.
So it's an undue hardship.
There you go.
Moved and supported. Roll call, please.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. DeBartolomeo?
Yes.
Mr. Randlett?
Yes.
Mr. Alexander?
Yes.
Mrs. Moore Porter?
Yes.
Mr. Campbell, no. Mr. Diak?
Yes.
Motion passes.
Have a great evening, gentlemen.
Thank you.
Good evening.
Who's doing, can I ask who's doing electronics on it?
To be a watch fire display. Watch fire. So.
All LED?
All LED, watch fire, long time reputable.
Yeah, get a good warranty on them.
I won't install some of the stuff that's out there. I just won't do it.
Software is easier to work with. There's a lot of pluses to it.
Yeah, it doesn't make sense. It's a lot of this import stuff. Doesn't have the dimming controls. Doesn't have the night capability. You can't get the parts for it. It just doesn't make sense. So,
thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. Campbell, next item.
Next item, petitioner is Vincent Joe's Gourmet Market. It's a request for a variance to allow a second wall sign at 41790 Garfield Road. There were 144 letters sent to owners and occupants within 300 feet. Three returned as undeliverable. No written replies were received.
Is petitioner here? Step forward. Name and address for the record, please.
Hello, I'm Rebecca Godin. I'm with Phillips Sign and Lighting, and our address is 40920 Executive Drive.
Go ahead and state your case, please.
So we are requesting a variance for a second sign for Vincent Joe's. Currently, they did have about 214 square foot on the building, and we're requesting the second sign for them.
Where is it located?
On the front elevation, Garfield.
Anything else?
Just that the building is approximately 216 feet from the road, and they have over 223 feet of frontage. It's also partially blocked by the building that's in the front, the gas station, and we want to be able to give them proper identification just to avoid any confusion and helping people identify the building safely. And adequately.
Okay, anything?
The only other thing is my The Vince and Joe's gentleman that was supposed to be here with me today is very ill, and so he kind of backed out last minute. So
no problem.
I'm representing them today.
No problem.
We know where to find them.
Yes.
Yeah.
He's the one doing all the building over there, so.
Anybody from the audience would like to speak to this matter? Opening it up to the board.
I got a comment.
Mr. DeBarmel.
Thank you. I think it's a good request. If you, all of us, I think, know Vince and Joe's pretty well. It was pretty chopped up. You had a lot of different businesses over the course of the years and different storefronts, and now they have taken over virtually that whole strip all the way to the sushi restaurant, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
So from there going south is all them. And if you look at it, and I'm probably there three times a week. I'm always looking at it, and looking at your drawings here. The marquee of the logo will be over where the new doors are at.
Mm-hmm.
So that's your front and center, people going in. And so then going south is where the other sign, we're just going to say Vince and Joe's. I think it's a good addition over there, because mm-hmm. there's a lot of frontage that's going south of those, of the new doors.
Yes.
People will enter. There's a lot of frontage going south.
And really, that's the visible spot.
Yeah.
But we want to identify
yeah.
the entrance.
So I think it's a good addition. I think it's subtle. I don't think it's gaudy. You know, I think it's a good addition to the building.
Yeah, we need to approve a new sign for the township entrance.
I can help you with that.
How to get in.
Mr. Campbell?
Yeah. Did the petitioner say that he currently has 214 square feet of signage?
That's just what we had figured out. We didn't build the original signs, but we've measured it over time, and so that's what we had determined. It was like over 200 or something.
Okay. According to the package we have, I think you're putting back what was currently
yep.
the previous
the old logo. Mm-hmm.
And that's shown as 154 square feet.
Mm-hmm.
So where is the other?
On the other end of the building, there's it says Vince and Joe's. But before, on the old building, there was produce, wine, beer, and meat, I think, that aren't going back up.
Ah, okay.
So that's some signs that we've taken down already and that they're not putting back up. So
okay.
Really, I think it ends up being like 15 more square feet than what they currently have. So
okay. I guess my comment, I see no problem with the request. The you know, typically this board has approved a lot of requests for multiple wall signs where the total of the wall signs is less than what would be allowed for one wall sign. Well, what's allowed for one wall sign on most establishments is 2 square feet times the frontage of the building,
mm-hmm.
which
would be 400 something.
I think it's 223 feet
yep.
of frontage,
mm-hmm.
which would allow
like 400 or 500
but
square feet.
The max that can be allowed is 200 square feet. You're only looking at a total of 225 square feet.
Yep.
So I don't think that's excessive. It also helps to make sure that people get to the right place within that big mm-hmm. parking lot.
And the building is going to look really nice, too. The finish of the building mm-hmm. is going to look beautiful.
Yeah, okay. I'll get it ready.
Yeah.
Not too beautiful right now, but.
No.
Anybody else from the board like to speak to this matter?
No, I think it's.
Okay, you need a motions in order?
I'll make a motion to grant the variance as requested based upon the undue hardship of ensuring public safety to get to the proper entrance to the establishment.
Support.
All right, who's supported?
It was a tie between Ken and I. I think he beat me just by a fraction or so.
Move and supported. Any further comments?
From the speaker.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Campbell, yes. Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Alexander?
Both yes.
Mrs. Moore Porter?
Yes.
Mr. Bartolomeo?
Yes.
Mr. Randlett?
Yes.
Mr. Diak?
Yes.
Motion passes.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Next case, please.
Last case, petitioner is Sharon Birkin at Sunspace Enclosures. Purpose of the request is for a variance to allow for a 33.27 foot setback to construct a sunroom on the property, which is only a variance of 1.73 feet from the required 35 feet. There were 182 letters sent to homeless occupants within 300 feet. None were returned as undeliverable.
Thank you, Mr. Campbell. State your name and address.
Christopher Rigney, 36511 Payne Street in Clinton Township, and I represent Sunspace Enclosures on behalf of Ms. Burkett. I do have a letter that Ms. Burkett got from a resident in support of this.
Can you step forward and give it to our secretary?
Thank you. This is from a resident at 20917 Park Place Lane, which obviously must be right across the street. And they voiced no objections to the request for the variance.
Thank you, Mr. Campbell. Go ahead.
What we're asking for today is less than 2 feet of variance. We're trying to construct, Sharon wants to build a, she right now with the southern exposure, she can't really, she doesn't enjoy the back porch at all or deck at all. The sunroom that we're trying to build is the exact same size as the deck that she currently has. We're not trying to take up any more space than what's currently ate up by a deck, but trying to give her a place that she can enjoy. It's just not enjoyable for her. We talked about just coming inside so that we wouldn't have to apply for the variance, but because her house has a bump out bay, coming into 10 feet just leaves her no room for the expense to build the structure. It would be pointless, really. She wouldn't be able to enjoy that space or put anything out there. So that's what we're asking for.
Okay, thank you. Any? Okay. Questions of the board? Go ahead, Mr. Campbell.
I was just going to make a motion
Good.
To approve.
Make a motion.
For something less than 2 feet.
Yeah.
There's wooded area behind it. I think every house should be allowed a sunroom.
You have a motion on the floor?
Support.
Make a
I'm sorry. I was jumping the gun over there. Yeah, sorry.
Let him jump in.
Okay. You want a formal motion to approve based upon the practical difficulty of the shallowness of the lot?
Support.
Anybody else?
Ken,
moving supported.
Support that?
No.
Mark.
Okay.
It's been moved and supported. It's been moved and supported. Roll call vote.
Mr. Campbell, yes. Mr. Alexander?
Votes yes.
Mrs. Amor Porter?
Yes.
Mr. DeBartolomeo?
Yes.
Mr. Pearl?
Yes.
Mr. Randlett?
Yes.
Mr. Diak?
Yes.
Motion passes.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Have fun with it.
Thank you very much.
Good luck.
Public comment?
Yeah, basically, I had a resident that actually, I was here at the meeting where on Suffolk Street, several months ago, a variance request was before the ZBA to allow a 6-foot privacy fence installed with the smooth side illegally on the purchaser's side. This went all the way around the property. Both neighbors on either side were complaining. The one part that was done correctly was the one facing towards the street. The smooth side is facing out towards the street. So in other words, the contractor knew what the proper way was. This is a self-created problem. It's not something that is a practical difficulty. The owners of the homes on each side appeared at the meeting to protest the installation and one to the removal of the existing cyclone fence against her wishes for the safety of her animals. The owner of the new fence, having been cited by the building department, gave no hardship unique to the property other than the expense of reinstalling the fence legally. As we all know, a financial hardship is not a reason for a variance. The ZBA voted to table the request until the owner went to mediation, and as of today's date, this has not taken place. The owner has never tried to do any of that. The planning director has told the owner requesting her cyclone fence be reinstalled as well as the new privacy fence being corrected that the ZBA did not put any timeline on the mediation. And there again, you can check the minutes to the meeting and the video. When a financial hardship is not allowed for a variance in any case, when will this variance request be denied? how long before the building department can finish up the violation, because they've got a violation notice against the people. And I'm curious, can the ZBA actually require mediation when the violated owners do not agree? And as a last thing, which isn't on this subject, I hope you all are looking at Velic Transportation to see what they've done. You know, you've given them years of extensions. They've done nothing. They're not worried about security. There's nothing protecting McDonald's from the dirt lot. The woman that owns the property to the north that was complained, nothing done there. So there again, that's my point.
Thank you, sir. Mm-hmm. Bruce, next meeting. I'm sorry.
Actually, you have
no,
first.
I'm sorry. The minutes.
Yeah.
Of last September 21st.
I did not have a chance to read them, so I have no comments.
Oh, well, actually, I got one small change. I had a chance.
Oh, wow.
Well, I probably missed a whole bunch of them, but on page 8, under reporting of the meeting, in the second paragraph, second line says, "With corrections noted, it's just two periods, probably just one period move." So, I was ready tonight.
Say that again.
So it was on page 8. It's two periods. Just need to remove one of them. Under reporting of the minutes for August 17th, second section, right after the word noted.
Thank you, Mark.
My pleasure.
Motion.
Mr. Chairman?
Yeah.
Let me add one comment. The second line of the that last paragraph on the next meeting schedule for Wednesday, October 19th. The second line should be October 19th, not August 17th.
Okay.
Got that also.
Anybody else? Need a motion?
Motion to approve with the two changes noted.
Support.
Who supported? Mark?
Yeah.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Okay, next item is the discussion on the next meeting agenda.
As of today, Board, we have one item. It's on Millar. It's a variance. A homeowner wants to add a second attached garage to the existing property.
Second attached? Is there a restriction on that?
Yes, there is. I haven't looked at it that deeply yet. It just came in last Friday. So just the information I got from Veronica before she went on vacay.
Mr. Chairman, can we put the fence back on the agenda since they're not doing anything?
We can request anything of any director we would like to. What does the board think?
I don't have a problem with, you know, I remember the case vividly, we all do.
Oh, yeah.
And you know, they were going to get down to brass tacks on it because of the violations that were being created there and money and everything. And I'm just kind of surprised to hear that nothing's been done at this point. So maybe we need to reel them in and say what's going on.
Well,
so,
Can I? Sure.
For me?
So obviously, the neighbor called me. I've talked to her a few times over the last few months. And I spoke to her day before yesterday and yesterday. I spoke with Mr. Miller, made him aware, as I told her I would do, of her concern that she had not been contacted. And so he asked me to communicate with the board and find out what your motion was. And so I did pull the minutes, and it said postpone until the petitioner is heard from again. So, you know, certainly I plan on speaking with Mr. Miller tomorrow. And at this point, you know, whether you want to call it back or he takes it to court, you know, I can't really say. I would suspect that the building department is the next step.
But we haven't denied it.
You haven't denied it, but you also postponed it. Specifically,
let's put it back on the agenda for an update.
Yeah,
and
should we have somebody from the building department here too?
I don't think it's up to them.
Well, but you said building department may be the next step.
I'm just talking about ours. You know, there's an open violation. Yeah. I don't know the status of that violation. If it's just a violation or if a ticket was issued,
but it's being held in abeyance while the decision right. is made.
To the decision.
It needs to come back. We need to deny it.
I mean, whatever
we
your
have to make a decision, your wishes. Yes or no.
Yeah, let's put it back on. If that's the wishes of the board?
Yes.
Okay. There should be a follow-up from the planning department to find out if they scheduled a mediation. When are they going to comply with the request?
Well, that'll be Bruce part of his report at next meeting.
Okay. Yeah, I did speak with the gentleman about a month after the meeting. Just briefly, he actually came into my office, so he wanted to double check the location, the place that you had recommended.
Okay.
And that was it. It was just a very brief conversation through the plastic.
Okay.
I will do that.
Motion in order to adjourn?
No. Oh, I had one more.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Is it, I wanted to talk about valet transportation. Should we bring that back to the board since they haven't done anything?
That is not something that would come back to this board.
Okay.
Not right away. And I have seen communication between the building department and valet transportation's representative basically saying the same thing. Time's up. You need to, either start pulling permits or, you're about to expire, and then they have to go back to court. Okay. So it would not be something that comes back to the Zoning Board of Appeals anytime soon.
Okay.
It's a horrific mess. It's been for 5 years.
Motion's in order. Oh, go ahead.
Motion to adjourn.
And I'll support it.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried.